Anon News. Twitter decides to censor locally, rather than block globally, in response to government demands. From the choices. Department while censorship is starting, folks, here we go. Twitter just announced that it has set up the ability to block content on a country-specific basis. For example, if Germany demanded some content be taken down, Twitter can now just have that content blocked in Germany. I know some people saw this and got upset about censorship. But looking at the details, it actually looks like Twitter is doing a smart thing here. You could argue that the proper response would be to stand up to local governments and say, "Sorry, we don't block anything," and I'd actually have sympathy with that response. But the truth is that if a government is demanding censorship, then Twitter is likely going to have to comply or face complete blocking. The solution that it came up with is somewhat more elegant. It will just block the specific content in the specific location and, importantly, will try to let users know that the content is blocked while also sending as much info as it can to the Chilling Effects website so that people can learn about what's being censored. This is a lot more transparent and hopefully actually shines more light on efforts to censor Twitter. As we continue to grow internationally, we will enter countries that have different ideas about the contours of freedom of expression. Some differ so much from our ideas that we will not be able to exist there. Others are similar but, for historical or cultural reasons, restrict certain types of content, such as France or Germany, which ban pro-Nazi content. Until now, the only way we could take account of those countries' limits was to remove content globally. Starting today, we give ourselves the ability to reactively withhold content from users in a specific country, while keeping it available in the rest of the world. We have also built in a way to communicate transparently to users when content is withheld, and why. We haven't yet used this ability, but if and when we are required to withhold a tweet in a specific country, we will attempt to let the user know, and we will clearly mark when the content has been withheld. As part of that transparency, we've expanded our partnership with Chilling Effects to share this new page, http://chillingeffects.org/twitter, which makes it easier to find notices related to Twitter. Oh, one useful tidbit of info. While it says it hasn't had to use this country-by-country blocking yet, and it uses the example of Nazi-related content, the place where it's already been censoring content, is in the United States. In response to DMCA complaints, as per Danny Sullivan, Twitter's already been pulling content where piracy or copyright claims are lodged under the existing DMCA law. Today's announcement isn't changing that, though potentially, Twitter might begin disclosing DMCA takedowns within its own search results and Twitter timelines. That doesn't happen yet, but Twitter says it hopes to do so over time. We've covered some of those activities in the past, and if this actually brings more attention to highly questionable takedowns, such as many we've seen issued to Twitter, that might actually be a good thing. We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.